won't be needing those. That belongs in the library. Changed my life, that book. You should read it. Just because you've got a soul-destroying job doesn't mean you haven't got a soul. Your spiritual essence has been floating around the cosmos for billions of years. I know. Pretty mind-blowing.
Load of rubbish.
Not turning into a bleeding heart liberal, are you?
Well, apparently restorative justice gives equal weight to the perpetrator as the victim.
Well, that's just it. Why should the criminal have the same rights? He sacrificed his rights as soon as he broke into your home, but only he didn't, because the great British justice system is more concerned for the criminal than the victim.
So is that a yes, then?
Hmm?
To my leave request?
Yes. If you think it's going to help.
You've changed your tune.
Well, I saw the mediator last week and she thinks it may give me closure.
It'd be nice to think so. Only don't expect too much. That way you won't be disappointed.
Waiting for a parcel in palatial splendour. Yeah, that'd be 150 quid, please, mate.
Jack, just remember the client's instructions. Touch nothing.
Why, Em, you'd be like a pig in poo here.
Loads of objet d'art, paintings, sculptures. Hold on.
Yeah, texting you a bit of retro pseudo postmodernism.
Or is it postmodernism?
Do you even know what that means?
I know what I like.
Right, well, do not leave so much as a fingerprint. I mean it. If you do a good job of this, then he could be a returning customer.
I am the invisible man.
All right, later then.
Oh, Denise, how are you keeping?
Oh, not so good, Karen. Emphysema, angina. Got the Grim Reaper breathing down my neck.
Oh, tell him to clear off.
Oh, don't fear death. It only brings me closer to Mickey.
You coped ever so well.
He's up there somewhere, looking out for me. He's been trying to get in touch. That's what they say.
They?
Been speaking to a psychic. She says there's something unresolved. Something Mickey's desperate to tell me.
Oh, Denise, it's an 0900 number.
I'm all set up now for the seance. But I could do with someone else.
And you mean me?
How are you fixed this evening?
No, not tonight, I promise, Rob.
I haven't got your mobile number.
See, the thing is, I don't really go in for the occult.
Mrs. Forster?
Now then, she will scare away the Grim Reaper.
He's been in there over an hour now. The house is registered to a Dr. Lionel Meaching. He was a founder member of the Church of Cosmic Enlightenment or something. Oh, well done. I'll call you back.
I've added a few more questions to the list.
Mm. Are these questions or statements?
Well, they're questions, aren't they?
Rather closed ones. They could seem like value judgments, and we want to avoid that.
So there are no unsuitable answers, only unsuitable questions?
I just want to make sure you get the answers you're looking for. You seem a bit on edge.
It was all a bit abstract before, and now I know it's really happening.
That's perfectly normal. But if you're uncomfortable, having second thoughts...
No, it's fine. I'm ready whenever he is.
Mickey. Mickey just rang.
Mickey?
Denise's dead son.
You just spoke to Denise's dead son?
He breathed down the phone at me and then he hung up.
Well, maybe she knows more than one Mickey. Or maybe she gave his phone to a friendly pervert.
Why would she do that?
I don't know, Mom. Why didn't you ask her?
A bit. I remember you running around in nappies. I thought you were still...
I've paid my debt to society. More than can be said for your son.
Mickey's dead.
So they say. I wanted to see his death certificate all the same. I told him that Harley was a death trap. Very inconsiderate.
I'd like you to leave now before...
I could have snitched on Mickey. Slashed my sentence, but I didn't. You know why? Said the money was all mine. Said he'd hidden it somewhere safe. Only he refused to tell me where. That was his insurance policy.
Mickey was a good boy.
Not around security corvans, he wasn't. If the driver had pulled off his balaclava and not mine, he'd be safely locked up.
He never had any money.
He adored you, didn't he?
Yes. Yes, he did.
Told you everything. Now, you're gonna tell me.
This must be where the governor hosts his cheese and worm pies.
Please, take a seat. Well, thanks for joining us, Mr. Brown. Dr. Carter has every hope this will be really positive. I'm sure you feel the same way.
Absolutely. 100%. And can I just say that I'm sorry for all the hurt and grief that I've caused, and I wish that I could press rewind and undo all the bad things that I've done. And I know that coming here can't have been easy for you. So thanks. It means a lot.
Just tell me where it is.
You expect me to believe that Mickey had a fortune squirreled away? He still used to ask for pocket money.
Yes, because he buried it. Knew I'd kill him if he touched a single note. Where did he bury it? Think.
How would I know? I wasn't a mind reader then, and I'm certainly not one. Of course, we could always ask Mickey himself. A psychic told me that his spirit is trying to break through, convey some sort of message.
You shouldn't mess about with that stuff. Sends harmful vibrations into the spirit realm.
Since when are you the Dalai Lama?
That's not Buddhism. I belong to the Church of Cosmic Enlightenment.
Oh, yes. What have that got to say about illegal firearms?
Got special dispensation. Sometimes the ends justify the means.
What are you doing?
I need to run this by my spiritual advisor.
You forgot your phone. You didn't call it earlier, did you, from Mickey's old phone?
No.
Oh. It's weird, because forget about the sales. You've got a hotline to the hereafter right there. Oh, no. I don't think we...
I'm an old friend of Mickey's. The kettle's just boiled. Why don't you join us?
Oh, no, thank you.
No, really, I insist.
Okay, lovely.
We could do with someone else, make up the numbers.
I'd say ons, no thanks. Three's a grand and all that, four if you can, Mickey. I'd ruin it, so I'd best be making tracks.
No one's going anywhere. You better hope this works. No, you don't. Give me that. You best try set the scene. A few joss sticks, candles. See what you can do.
You have no idea how pleased I am to see you. Cheers. Don't be a stranger.
Bad, thanks. It only hurts when I laugh, which isn't too often in here. It's a shame you're not a footballer instead.
It's all right.
Well, you gave me a real hammering with a cricket bat.
Is anybody there? Mickey? Can you hear me, love? It's me. Mom, I miss you so much, sweetheart. Can't bring myself to pack away your things. Your room's just as you left it. Apart from those magazines. I think there's something you want to tell me, isn't there? I can send you presents. Give me a sign.
I'm so sorry. I could just explain how it with my sinuses.
Jack, please tell me that you haven't broken anything.
I broke something. A vase.
Oh! I could have trained a chimpanzee to do this job. I just hope they don't sue us. For someone who's supposed to be clever, you are a right doofus, you know that?
Lift going down.
Right. Where's your mum?
Mrs. Forster's.
Oh, she's not answering her phone. She bends my ear about late night shopping, then goes AWOL.
Well, don't expect me to push the trolley. I've got to sort out Jack's latest disaster.
Mickey, an old friend of yours is here. Mrs. Holroyd's boy, Ryan. Remember that time on your 13th birthday? He almost blinded me with a paper spitball. Terrible acne. That's all cleared up now. Mickey, he says you need to tell me something. You need to tell us where you hid the money. I don't know. The atmosphere can't be right. The supernatural frequencies are blocked.
Maybe it's your satellite dish mucking up the reception.
You both need to try harder, or I'll send your spiritual essence towards its next manifestation.
Maybe it's because there's a non-believer present.
Yeah, probably, yeah, I'll get my coach.
So you're a sceptic?
No, I'm a good C of E girl. I'm admittedly not a regular churchgoer.
You believe in a life after this one? You believe that death is not the end?
Yeah, totally.
Then say it.
I am sure that there is life after this one and that death is not the end.
Okay, good. Now, get on with the seance.
It's affected me in ways I would never have imagined. I have this constant, unshakable anger. And I can't believe that a total stranger would make me feel so unlike me.
Yeah, I can understand that.
Can you?
Yeah. You're a proper gent, aren't you? You sort of know how to keep everything buttoned up. But you see, in here, the guys are animals. They can't control their instincts. Violent instincts. But for your sort, you keep that violence buried deep. So when a scumbag like me gives you a chance to feel that deep primal rage, I bet it takes you by surprise.
It's moving.
Just keep one finger on the planchet. Let it move of its own accord.
Mickey! It's about Mickey!
He was here all along. We need to find the folding stuff, Mickey. Can you tell us where you hid it?
Veg!
Veg?
Mickey, what do you mean by veg? I can feel his absence.
So what does he mean?
He grew his own veg. At the allotment.
Get in. You drive. And you, in the front. Thank you.
My nan, she was the only one that believed in me. And the worst of it is that I've let her down. Even she's ashamed of me now. And who can blame her?
Good. Okay. Heston, is there anything else you'd like to discuss?
Absolutely.
This is it. Mickey's patcher.
You, start digging.
I can understand theft, the pilfering of valuable items, but the pointless vandalism and destruction.
Well, like I said, I don't know what I was thinking. The animal in me
took. An animal wouldn't behave like that. You had nothing to gain by slashing my paintings and emptying my bottles of vintage wine, and you did it, what, out of envy? Spite?
Curtis?
I don't know.
Look, I have had enough of this. Oh?
Pull it out, quick!
All right, I wouldn't want you to break a sweat. Doc!
You are gonna regret that.
That's for the spitball! Oh, you've knocked him out cold! Fancy a trip to Vegas?
The model ship you smashed. A gift from my late father. One of the most treasured mementos I have ruined in a moment of futile violence. And the photo album of my son's childhood also ruined. Not to mention the very choice fine wines, carefully selected over 2 decades!
You mentioned those.
What?
Your very choice fine wines.
Watch out!
That's my heart bleeding for you on the table. Poor little rich man. Even your girlfriend picked on you, didn't she?
I suggest we wrap things up.
No, you bang on about all this sentimental stuff, when really what riles you is the knowledge that a lowlife like me can come into your precious fortress and mess up your stuff. Trinkets and charms. They make you know how special you are, innit? How much better you are than the rest of us. You, sir, make me sick.
I promised the money to my church. We were hoping to set up a new centre in Sutton Coalfield.
Mm. Oh, yeah, your mate, Dr. Meacher. In a former life, he was Gary Patterson. Twice convicted for mail fraud. Was more interested in large cash donations than spiritual enlightenment.
You're lying, aren't you?
You want to pray that the judge takes pity on you. If you get a good lawyer, you might get out in 4 years.
Where was my knight in shining armour when I actually needed him?
If you will insist on being abducted by gun-toting criminals, there's only so much I can do.
Is that all the thanks I get?
For what?
Doing your flipping job for you.
You were okay, I suppose, but then again, you did learn from the best.
Yeah, right.
This is going to take me quite a while to live down. Thanks. See you back at the ranch, Inspector Hollins.
There are more things in heaven and earth.
Not half.
Hey, maybe you could put me in touch with a few of my dead relatives. I've got a few things to ask. Great Aunt Ethel had a bone china tea service. Where's that for a start?
I moved it.
Hey?
I moved the planchette. It wasn't Mickey.
So you knew where the money was all along?
No. I didn't. Just before Mickey died, he came out of the coma. Couldn't speak properly. Kept making this noise. Sounded like rage or fidge. I didn't know what he was getting at.
But during the séance, I finally realised what it meant. Why he'd said it. I so wanted to speak to him!
Oh, but he did speak to you! Oh, he must have known that lunatic would pay a visit. More than anything, he wanted you to be okay.
He was no angel.
Oh. I know. But he's with the angels now, and best leave him up there, eh? Oh, come on, I'll take you.
I only apologised to Lop some time after sinner.
Oh, come on.
You looked me in the eye and lied to me all afternoon.
Yeah. But now I know what a smug, pompous git you are. I'd rather keep my dignity.
Dignity? Is this some kind of joke?
I think we're done.
How are you feeling, Mandy?
Fine, thank you.
If you want to talk...
I don't. Thank you.
Lewis.
My health is my responsibility. And everything else is none of your business. The future almost...